Well, the best seat in the House tonight is at South Bank, where a live site has been set up for the announcement. So let's cross to Claire Barnes. Claire, no doubt the excitement is really starting to build down there.
Yeah, that's right, Sandra. We may be the red-hot favourite, but I can tell you there's still plenty of nervous excitement building here as we wait to see if it's game on for Brisbane. This has been 6 years in the making. We're about to find out if the world's greatest sporting event is coming to Queensland in 2032. The celebrations have already kicked off here at South Bank, with many families rolling in to watch the live entertainment and listen to Olympians up on stage before the big decision is beamed on the big screen. If it all goes to plan, there will be a huge fireworks display set off, and the city's landmarks like the Story Bridge lit up in green and gold. Now, insiders are fairly confident that Brisbane has this in the bag, but as you just heard, it's not necessarily a done deal, and we will just have to wait for that crucial IOC vote. What we do know is that Queenslanders love to win and love their sport, so there will be millions of people right across the state watching this decision. Celebrations in the River City kicked off very early this morning. Our reporter John Paul Gonzo has more on this historic moment for Queensland.
We've jumped through all the hoops. And in just over an hour, we should hopefully close the deal. For years, we've heard about how the games will change our city. Now it's time to witness it.
And the place will explode. We've seen images from all over the world as they announce their Olympic cities. We remember back to 93 when it was for Sydney. This is Brisbane's time to shine, and I'm so excited and can't wait.
That excitement was building from sunrise at City Hall, where Brisbane's Olympic dream was born, to the Gabba, where the opening ceremony will play out. The big sell started early, including a final message from two people with the weight of the state on their shoulders, the Premier and Lord Mayor, calm before the biggest pitch of their lives.
I never thought that we would be sitting in this position now, on the cusp of Brisbane, Queensland being awarded the 2032 Olympic and Paralympic Games.
And tonight we can show you how Queensland will be showcased to the world. This video highlights the state's natural beauty, our First Nations history, world-class stadiums and existing infrastructure, and a connected capital city with links to the regions to make the Games for all.
All of that will go together to be part of our sales pitch, to be part of our bid.
It won't be cheap, but it will be worth it. The Olympic and Paralympic Games will cost $5 billion, with the Gabba redevelopment the big ticket item.
I will be receiving significant funding from the International Olympic Committee. We'll be receiving significant funding from sponsorship and from ticket sales.
It might seem like this has all come together at the very last moment, but it has taken 6 years and a vision shared by the local, state and federal government. A bond that has been tested but never broken, and it's that cooperation credited with propelling our bid to first place.
It'll drag us out of this current situation. It'll drag us into the future. There is a future, and we can start building it right now.
And beyond the tourism boost and infrastructure improvement, it gives the next generation the chance to dream.
The Olympics is amazing.
Olympic people are like the best in the world.
And what a place to have it than right here at home. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.